Hi, I'm Josiah from the band 16 Cities, and this is my friend Rick Brown. We're here to talk to you guys about The Depth of Your Love, a song that we wrote together right here in this room following a powerful night of worship. You see, the band and I, when we first moved to Texas, we felt led to gather in people's homes and do worship nights where we could pray together for the church, where we could worship for hours and just spend time seeking the Lord together. And Rick and his wife were the first to open their doors that we could do these worship nights right here in their house.
And in our church, we've had such a focus this year on infusing God's word. And the way we do that is we read, we reflect, and then we respond. One of the ways that I respond to God's word often is through music, through song. And this song, The Depth of Your Love, is literally our response to the beautiful passage that we find in Ephesians chapter 3.
Ephesians 3, 14 through 19 is a prayer by the Apostle Paul for the early Christians in Ephesus. And in this prayer, he says this: "For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant you to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and the length, the height, and the depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God." You see, Paul was desperate that the Christians in the early church would know the fullness of God's love. But that begs the question, what is the love of Christ? Why is his love so deep and so wide? Well, the first thing we know about God's love, the love of Christ, is that it is unending. The Bible says it knows no bounds, that his love endures forever and lasts through the ages, that he never fails us, never leaves us, never forsakes us. Rick Warren says it this way, that God's love is like an ocean. You can see the beginning, but not its end. You know, I think about the times I've been at the beach, looking out at the ocean and realizing that as hard as I try, there's no way I could ever see the other side. The ocean is too great to comprehend. Well, in the same way, God's love for us, the love of Christ, knows no bounds. We'll never even be able to see the end of it because it is so expansive. The other beautiful thing about the love of Christ is that it is unequaled. Psalm 36:6 says it this way, "Your righteousness is like the mighty mountains, your justice like the ocean depths." Now, the word justice in this world means you get what you deserve. But the beautiful thing about the justice of God is that it's not about us earning anything, but instead, the love of God is a free gift that Christ earned for us on the cross. In fact, Romans 5:8 says this, that even while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
And in Ephesians 2:8, it says, "For by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not of your own doing, it is the gift of God." And in order to convey this, we wanted the words of the song, the lyrics to proclaim, it's not about us rowing and straining to get into God's current. His current is so powerful, it's unending, it's unequaled, it's strong. As we say, the current is strong and the wind is the song of your love.
So as we sing this song, The Depth of Your Love, we can have confidence in the fact that Christ is the one that went before us and did the work on the cross, so that we do not have to work and toil and try to become perfect and try to be good enough, but instead can fall into the grace of God and fall into his love. Here's the beautiful thing. The love of Christ is an ocean wide. Our sins are separated from us as far as the east is from the west because of the finished work of Jesus on the cross. So instead of trying to work and earn your salvation and trying to be good enough for the love of God, we can instead have confidence that Jesus is enough and that all we have to do is fall into the depth of his love and let the current of his love carry us away.
Your love is an ocean.